silver blue eyes, and I really, 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 really love her nails and her phone case and her purse. And also everything else about her.
My mom's so cute, and I love her she, and I love her. And her, my best friend.
I love my mom because she takes care of me and she cuddles me.
What do we know about your mom?
That when I am sick, she takes care of me.
What I love about my mom is when I'm sad, she cheers me up.
I love my mom because she takes care of me.
Her because she always kisses my boob when we always go everywhere to eat, and I love her so much. And so much, we always go to church and we always go swimming.
I like cooking mommy, and I like doing funny things with her, and I also love mommy a bunch and doing stuff with her and playing with her all night. And I love her too much, and I like giving her hugs. Playing with her all night, dancing with her, and I like going picnics with her and doing everything I like. Happy Mother's Day.
I love my mom because we're going to Hawaii, and all because of her work, and I love her. I just love her so much, and she might get me a dog when we have a new house.
I love my mommy so much because she always buys me toys, but no more because they always rip the toys and the dresses. And I'm cutting my friend's hair. And we always go eat at dinner, and we always go at church and everything. And I still love her so much, and she's my mommy because I keep God with her every time.
What do you love about your mom?
I love her nails, I love her blonde hair, love her blue eyes, and I really, 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 really love her nails and her phone case and her purse. And also everything else about her.
My mom's so cute, and I love her, and her, my best friend.
I love my mom because she takes care of me and she cuddles me.
What we love about your mom?
That when I am sick, she takes care of me.
What I love about my mom is when I'm sad, she cheers me up.
I love my mom because she takes care of me.
Her because she always kisses my boob when we always go everywhere to eat, and I love her so much. And so much, we always go to church and we always go swimming.
I like cooking mommy, and I like doing funny things with her, and I also love mommy a bunch and doing stuff with her and playing with her all night, and I love her too much, and I like giving her hugs, playing with her all night, dancing with her, and I like going picnics with her and doing everything I like. Happy Mother's Day.
I love my mom because we're going to Hawaii, and all because of her work, and I love her. I just love her so much, and she might get me a dog when we have a new house.
I love my mommy so much because she always buys me toys, but no more because they always rip the toys and the dresses. And I'm cutting my friend's hair. And we always go eat at dinner, and we always go at church and everything. and I still love her so much, and she's my mommy because, and I keep God with her every time.
What do you love about your mom?
I love her nails, I love her blonde hair, love her blue eyes, and I really, 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 really love her nails and her phone case and her purse. And also everything else about her.
My mom's so cute, and I love her so sweet, and I love her, and her mother.
Morning! How are you guys doing? Happy Mother's Day to all you mothers. Let's worship together on this beautiful day.
I was lost with a broken heart. You picked me up, now I'm set apart. From the ash I'm born again, forever safe in the Savior's hands. You are more than words can say. I follow you, Lord, for all my days. Fix my eyes following your ways, forever free in unending grace. Come on.
Day, Mom.
Thank you, baby.
Yeah, happy Mother's Day, everybody. Man, what a beautiful day to be together. And we are so excited about what God has in store for each and every one of us today. Let's sing this out.
Mother, why art thou beginning?
one with God the Lord Most High. Your hidden glory in creation now revealed in you, our Christ. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus. Didn't want heaven without us. So Jesus, you brought heaven down. Love was, your sin was great, your love was greater. What could separate us now? What a wonderful name it is. Death could
for him.
Church, before you're seated, I want you to turn around and just say hello to someone, high five them, and you guys may be seated. Well, welcome to New Life Church. We want to welcome everybody who's here with us in person and everybody who's watching us online as well. Thank you for joining us. Happy Mother's Day to all the mamas in the house. You know, my name is Camilla Ranger, and I have the honor and privilege of being your campus pastor here at the Southwest Campus of New Life Church. And we're just so glad that you're here. We know that we have a lot of first-time guests today, and so we just want to welcome you to our house. We hope that you feel at home here. We hope that you feel like you belong. If this is your first time with us, in the seat in front of you, there is a Connect card. Or if you're watching us online, you can go to our website or our church app and fill out a Connect card. We'd love to just get to know you, learn more about you and your family and how we can serve you in this season. If you're here in person, when you fill out the Connect card here in just a moment, we're going to pass our offering buckets. You can drop it in there, or you can take it out to our Welcome Center after the gathering, where we'd love to just answer any questions that you have. Well, we have some beautiful things that are happening around the campus, and I'm sure that you have seen them. We've been doing a remodel, a rebrand project since January, and that is because of your generosity. You'll see a video playing behind me where things have been happening. You can see on the south building today that the stain went up. We're going to be pulling out these windows shortly and redoing the sides of the worship center. We have a new monument on the corner. We ran into some electrical issues, but it's coming too. But you guys know, there are statistics that say that during COVID and after the pandemic, that if you're building in the middle of a project or you're building in construction, it's costing 50% more money and it's taken 50% more time. But can I tell you that God has been faithful to us? And even with all of the things that have happened, we have stayed under budget and we're moving because our God is faithful and he's been pulling strings that we could never do. And we're grateful for that. But thank you for your generosity to take care of our central campus. We're so grateful for your heart to serve this house, not only with the building and the aesthetics, but also what we can contribute and do out of this building to take care of our community. Let's pray over our tithe and our offering. Father, we just thank you for these gifts. Lord, we ask that as we receive these gifts today, God, that you will bless them. Lord, that you will multiply them and you will bless the giver. Father, help us to continue to steward these gifts well. And Lord, help us to continue to use this tithe and this offering, Lord, to be your hands and your feet to this community. God, help us to be your light in dark places. Lord, we give you back what you have already given us, and we ask that you multiply it. In your name we pray, amen. Amen. Well, today we have a beautiful opportunity as a church family to be a part of child dedications. And can I just say that I know that for some today is a challenging day. But as I was preparing for child dedication, I was thinking about the story of Hannah in the Bible. And I was thinking about how she believed that she was going to be barren. And as she was seeking the Lord, what she said to God was, "If you will give me this child, I will dedicate him back to you." And as I was reading this scripture, sorry, I'm losing all my things, I apologize. 1 Samuel says, "As surely as you live, my Lord, I am the woman who stood here beside you praying to the Lord. I prayed for this child, and the Lord has granted me what I asked for. So now I give him to the Lord. For his whole life, he will be given over to the Lord." And he worshiped the Lord there. So we have the honor and we have the privilege of being part of these dedications today. So I want you guys to meet our babies and our children who are getting dedicated. Let me step over here out of the way. So we have Valentina. Valentina, can you say hello to everyone? Look at her. I love it. And Mom Liliana. And then we have Henry. Hi, sweet baby. And Mom Katie. Hello. And we have Alizé. Can you say hi? Look. And we have Mom Victoria. So it is our honor and our privilege to dedicate your children today. But what this is, guys, is it is an opportunity for us as a church family to lift our hands here in just a moment when Pastor prays over these babies and these children, for us to take a moment as a church family and extend our hands as a sign of blessing, for us to say that we are going to pray over these moms and support these children as they are dedicating their children back to God. Because you guys know that our children are just on loan to us, right? The Lord has given us the opportunity to raise them up in the way that they would go so that when they are old, they will not depart from it. So parents, if you will just say, I will, after each vow, we are going to be a part of just saying back to the Lord, we give these babies back to you, and we promise to raise them as best as we can in the way of Scripture and the promises of God. Parents, will you acknowledge your child as a gift to you from God? Will you promise to raise your child in a loving Christian environment? Will you teach your child God's word? Will you tell your child of God's love for them and his gift of everlasting life through his son, Jesus? Will you pray with and for your child and teach your child to pray? Will you do your best to imitate Christ in all that you do and all that you say? Will you be faithful to God and teach and train your child to trust him? Will you commit yourself to doing all that you can to support your child in their spiritual growth at home, at church, and in the world, in hopes that one day they too will choose him as their Lord and their Savior? Absolutely. Pastor James, will you bless these children?
A blessing up towards these precious little ones, these moms. Father, in the holy name of Jesus, we speak blessing. Blessings from heaven of wisdom. The power of the Holy Spirit will indwell them to help them be everything that you want them to be, Lord. To be parents that seek first the kingdom of God and your righteousness. Lord, we bless these children that in the name of Jesus, they will one day experience you in full measure when they come to that age of accountability. Thank you for the gift of life, Lord, that comes from you. All life comes from you and is sacred. And we thank you for it. In Jesus' strong name we pray. Amen and amen. Can we celebrate these parents, these babies? Good job, guys. Good job.
Can we give it up for all the moms in the house? Come on. Yeah.
Well, happy Mother's Day to everyone. Every lady, I'm sorry, every mother. Why am I so nervous all of a sudden? I think it's because I usually ask permission when I do certain things, but Pastor always says when you know, go. Mm-hmm. So this morning, I would like to share some information with all of you. As you guys know, Rachel and I have been dating, had dated for a while, and we got married in March, right? And I didn't think of another place or moment, more fitting moment to announce that we are expecting a baby. Woo! I got that out now. We love you guys, and we are just so happy to share that with you guys. Well, back to our regularly broadcast demo.
We should sing a song. We should sing a song about moms because of this.
Absolutely. Let's do it.
What's the right one, though? Mama, I just killed a man. No, that can't be it.
We can't do that.
No, you're right, dude. You're right. I didn't think about that. I just heard mama.
I thought there was a song that this is Pop's favorite song, I think.
Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys.
Wow, that's a low blow to all our Cowboys fans.
What's the other one? I drew a blank. Mama tried to raise me better, but I plead night and night. That leaves only me to blame, but mama tried.
Hey, you turned out all right.
You tried hard, mama. You tried hard. I do have one. I have a good one. So when we had back-to-back children. I mean, like, back-to-back. They're 11 and a half months apart. And so going into our second child, Caden, she, you can imagine, she was going through a lot. And I didn't know what to do. I was like, we were babies. We were like 23 or something like that. And I wrote this song for her. And I haven't sung it in a long time, so let's do it now. See yourself when you look in the mirror. Your self-consciousness grows more every day. You say you don't like how your clothes don't fit right. I see your frustration all over your face, but you've never been more beautiful to me. Your judgment for yourself grows by the hour. It breaks my heart to hear the claims that you make, like I am not pretty or I'm a bad wife. Sweetheart, you are the love of my life, and you've never been more beautiful to me. Through my eyes, I could not love you more. And the changes you're seeing is God's way of making room for this baby inside. I'll have to accept the fact that I'm not the only man which your heart belongs. And honey, I pray that our boy someday will find someone as special as the woman his head lays on. If you could see what I see, you have never been more beautiful to me. You have never been more beautiful to me. Happy Mother's Day.
So, speaking of Camilla, ladies and gentlemen, we are not only a... not only a special day in that it's Mother's Day. Ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow, Pastor Camilla turns 40 years old. Let's watch the screens. Let's give it up one more time, Pastor Camilla. Happy 40th birthday to you. Well, happy Mother's Day to all of you here at New Life Church Southwest. Welcome to those of you who are joining us at New Life Church Northwest as well and our online community. Happy Mother's Day, everybody. Can we give it up for the mothers everywhere? Come on, let's give it up. I honor the mother of this house, the mother of my two sons, Miss Lydia Ranger. I love you. You're the best. You're the best. I want to also honor my mother, who will be watching this, my mom. Let's put a picture up on the screen. This is my dear mom. And right there she is. Right there she is. Now listen, now you know who gave me my love for fishing. It wasn't my dad. It was my mom. And, you know, moms say some really strange things. Like my mama one time, she said, son, I'm warning you, if you fall out of that tree and you break both of your legs, don't come running to me. What? I love what Michelle Pfeiffer, the actress Michelle Pfeiffer, said. She said, like all parents, my husband and I just do the best we can and hold our breath and hope we've set aside enough money to pay for our kids' therapy. Anybody relate to that one? Mm-hmm. And also, well, Sam Levinson said, insanity is hereditary. We get it from our kids. We get it. Any moms in the house agree with that? Northwest, you agree with that? We're in the series on restore. God restores our brokenness. And the reason why we all need this message is because we all get broken in life. But Jesus is the restorer. I heard a story this last week, a true story about a guy who broke his arm. He's a dude that was too proudful to be honest about what happened, but finally he came clean. This is what he did. This is what happened. So his wife brought in some plants from outside on the patio, and unbeknownst to her, there was a garter snake curled up in one of them. And she sat it down in the living room, and that garter snake got out and started crawling across the floor. Well, the dude was in the bathroom taking a hot bath, and he heard his wife scream like she's being murdered. I mean, I would too. I scream like a little girl when I see a snake. I hate snakes. That's just true. So he thinks that she's being murdered. So he literally jumps out of the bathtub, forgets the towel. He runs in there, you know, in all of his glory. And she says, there's a snake under the couch. And so he gets down on all fours and is looking under the couch for the snake. And about that time, his dog comes up and cold noses him. And he thinks it's a snake. Has bit him in the behind. And he faints, passes clean out, and when he wakes up, he's droggy, and she thought he had a heart attack, and that she had, you know, she called the ambulance, they get him on the gurney, and they're taking him out, and that snake came out from underneath the couch, and one of the medics got so frightened, he dropped his side of the stretcher, and he says, that's how I broke my arm. The truth is, we all get broken in life, right? We get broken sometimes because of stuff that we do to ourselves. Sometimes we get broken because of what others do to us. But we get broken in life. But the good news is that Jesus the Restorer wants to restore every area of our life. That's the good news of Jesus. But if you're going to experience true restoration in your life, you have to move beyond what I call the number one hurdle to restoration, that is denial. Denial. Denial is when I accuse others and excuse myself. If Lydia would just get her act together, I would not be the way I am. Denial is also when we do the thing, you've said it probably, I'm fine, it's all good. That's like the person jumping off the 20-story building, he's halfway down, and you overhear him say, so far, so good. No, dude, you're in denial. Most of us do not move into recovery, into healing, restoration in our lives until first we're forced into it. So God gives us three denial busters in order to move us past our denial. The first one is crisis. Crisis. Crisis is when just you lose your job, you lose your health. Crisis hits. The second denial buster is what I call confrontation. That's when somebody loves you enough to tell you the truth. Hey, listen, you're about to lose your job. You're about to lose your wife, your family. Come on, man, you're better than that. Down in Texas, they have a saying. The saying goes something like this. If one person tells you that you're a horse's rear, ignore it. If two people tell you you're a horse's rear, look in the mirror. If three people tell you you're a horse's rear, buy a saddle. If three people tell you you're an alcoholic, buy a saddle. If three people tell you you're struggling with bitterness, buy a saddle. If three people tell you you're a rageaholic, then you need to buy a saddle. In other words, God allows loving people to confront us out of denial. Crisis, confrontation, and then catastrophe. Now, this is when the bottom just drops out. Some of you experienced this recently. Happens in our finances. Happens in our relationships. It happens in all areas of our lives. When all of a sudden, the bottom drops out, we feel totally out of control. And that's what forces us to say the words that God already knows, but we need to say them out loud. God, I can't do this without you. Lord, I'm out of control. I cannot control this uncontrollable situation, but you can. And we plug into the power of God, and that's when everything begins to turn. Listen, here's what I'm trying to say. To move into recovery, to move into restoration in our lives, we have to move past our denial and come into this hope stage, this place of hope. Hope that God's power is more than enough. Hope that we can recover. Hope that we can be restored. And there is a hope that God wants to give you today that will give you power to restore your life. I want to spend a few moments talking to you about these four keys to getting hope, that developing hope that will give you power to be restored. It's an acrostic. I know that surprises you. H-O-P-E. An acrostic of the word hope. The H stands for higher power. Now, some people feel real uncomfortable with calling Jesus, the Son of God, the higher power. Well, that's just meant for 12 steps. I beg to differ with you. I think the title higher power is accurate. I think it's spot on for Jesus. Because listen to some of the names for Jesus. Jesus is called God Most High.
How did I do that? That was nice.
He's called God Most High. He's called the Great High Priest. He's called the Son of the Highest. He's called the High and Holy One. He is seated at the right hand of the Father on high. Jesus is higher than anything and anybody. But Jesus is also power. Look at this verse in Romans 11:36. It's so powerful. Let's read it together. Ready to go. For everything comes from God alone. Everything. Do you believe that? There's nothing alive in the universe that is not alive without the power of Jesus Christ. So therefore, I suggest to you, he is the higher power. And restoration, recovery comes into my life when, first of all, I believe that he exists, that he is the higher power. There's none higher.
and that he has the ability to bring healing to the brokenness of my heart. And a lot of you say, "That's James, that's a no-brainer. I believe in God." I'm sure you do. In fact, a poll was recently taken that says that 97% of all Americans believe in God. Only 3% call themselves atheists anymore, where about 50 years ago, it was about 40, 50% would say, I'm an atheist. You know what happened? We got computers. Now it just doesn't it doesn't make sense. That's why the Bible says only a fool believes there is no God. Psalms 14:1, only a fool says there's no God. Why? Because wherever there is a creation, there has to be a creator. Wherever there is a design, there has to be a designer. And Jesus Christ is the power of God that created the heavens and the earth. And when you believe that in your heart, you begin to get hope that you can recover, that you can be what God wants you to be. Romans 1:20 says, "For since the creation of the world, God's invisible qualities, his eternal power and divine nature have been clearly seen." You go out on a starlit night, you look up and you go, whoa. You go get out on the blue ocean and you go look as far as you can see, go, whoa. You go to the Grand Canyon, you look down and you go, whoa. What? My God's power is revealed in creation, and that same God that can do that is the same God that lives inside of me. The issue with most of us is not do we believe in God. The issue is what kind of God do we believe in? Here's the thing. Unfortunately, a lot of us have our image of Father God based on our earthly parents. Now, some of you had great earthly parents. You know, they were just stellar. Well, you may have a good image of God. But a lot of people weren't so fortunate. And we all of us parents are flawed, right? All of us parents are flawed, aren't we? Two people, okay. I am flawed, and Lydia is not. It's Mother's Day. But the truth is, a lot of people see God, the Father, as they saw their parents. So if we had an unloving, uncaring, aloof parent, we transfer that onto God. If we had a parent that just was abusive or we're always afraid of them, we transfer that image onto God, that we see God only as this abusive Father that's ready to whack us every time we do something wrong. But here's the truth. The Bible says that your Father, your Abba, is the most loving, caring, patient person you can even imagine. That he loves you with crazy love. He's crazy about you. That is the God that is your higher power. And that power can restore your life. H-O. The O stands for open to change. Now, let me ask you a question. This is kind of a simple one, but let me ask you. How many of you would agree that if you are not open to change, if you don't believe you can change, you'll probably never change? Is that true? So what if you believe your attitude is, I can't change, I will never, I'm always going to be like this, and I have a negative attitude, and I believe that attitude, what's going to happen? You're never going to change, right? It's like the epitaph of a negative person. It says, I expected this. I knew this was going to happen. Yeah, I knew it. I just knew it. The first step to recovery and healing and restoration in our life is to begin to change our attitude, that I got to be open to change in my life. Ephesians 4, 23 and 24. I want everybody at both campuses, those of you online, let's all read this together right now. Ready, go. Now, your attitudes and thoughts must all be constantly changing for the better. Yes, you must be a new, the transformation, the change, the restoration begins on the inside of us. And I've got to be open to change. H, higher power. O, I have to be open to change. Now, before I give you the next one, I'm going to send it over to Pastor Kathleen and everybody over at the Northwest Campus. Would you give it up for Pastor Kathleen? We'll do it right here with you. Come on, let's give it up for Kathleen. Happy Mother's Day. H-O-P, this is where the central part of this message is, and that is the P stands for power to change. Power to change. You will not change, I will not change, only in our power. To be restored, to be healed, it takes the higher power of God, the power of the Lord Jesus. Philippians 4:13, I love this verse. For I can do some things. Is that what he said? What does it say? Everything. And everything means? Everything. Okay, he says, for I can do everything God asked me to do with the help of Christ, who gives me the strength and the... Oh my gosh, man, you got to get this. Where does the power come from? It comes from Christ. Christ means the anointed one. That the risen Christ is seated at the Father's right hand, and you can tap into the power of Jesus. Jesus will give you his divine power to change your life. Now, some of you come to this Mother's Day gathering, or you're watching online, and you just need to hear this. Because inside of you, you're going, there's no way that this is going to get better in my life. I mean, this thing is impossible. This is impossible in my life. But the Lord says to you, by my power, you can break that addiction. You're struggling right now, but my power is more than enough. My power will help you turn around that relationship. My power will help you to maintain your sanity, to get over your depression, because my power is within you, the power of the Holy Spirit. How many of you say, I need more power in my life? I certainly do. We need power. And one of the ways that we get power in our lives is to be baptized in water. What are you talking about? I thought that was just kind of a thing you did. You got splashed or dunked. And No. At water baptism, the Bible clearly spells out that your life is going to receive an infusion of power from heaven. Jesus modeled it himself. When he was baptized in water, remember that? He was baptized in water. And the scripture says this. In fact, let's put it up on the screen. This is not in your outline, but I want you to see it. As soon as Jesus was baptized, he went up out of the water. At that moment, heaven was opened, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting on him. Watch this. Jesus did not start his ministry. He did not cast out a demon. He did not raise the dead. He did not do anything spectacular or supernatural until he was baptized in water. There is something that God imparts to you when you follow his command in obedience to be baptized, immersed in water. 2 weeks from now on Sunday, we're going to have our baptism Sunday. And I want you, those of you that are not baptized in water by immersion, because here at New Life, we put you under. Just like Jesus was baptized, we put you under. You say, for how long? How much sin you got in your life? If you got a bunch... Just kidding. Kinda. Listen, we need to be washed by the Spirit. We need to be cleansed of our sins. And water baptism releases the power of the Holy One into your life. So I'm just challenging you right now. Commit. At the end of our service, go over to that baptistry right over there in the dark. You can't see it, but it's over there. And there'll be a baptism. And we'll have the lights on. My team will meet with you, and we will give you instructions. Or you can go online, and you can commit there. But listen, before the day's up, commit. Before this service is up, commit. Because some of you have been thinking about it for years. I'm saying get filled with the Holy Spirit. Get filled with the power of God to change your life. And that certainly happens through water baptism. All right? Now, I want to camp here for just a second on you receiving power. There are three truths about God's power, that gives you the power to change. The first truth is that God knows about your situation. How many of you know that God knows every detail of your life, including the pain you're in right now? The disappointments, the sorrow, what you experienced this last week. Some of you barely walked in those doors. Some of you barely joined us online right now because your heart is broke, even on Mother's Day. But here's the good news. God knows. The Bible says in Psalms 58, verse 8, it says, you know how troubled I am. You have kept a record of my tears? God, you know the trouble. You say, James, nobody knows what my relationship is right now. Wrong. Somebody knows. God knows. James, nobody knows this inner turmoil that I've been feeling. God knows. God sees. God knows everything you're going through. In fact, he keeps track of every tear that I cry. Every time you shed a tear, God keeps record of it. He knows. Psalms 31:7 says, you have seen the crisis in my soul. How many of you know that God sees every crisis in our soul? He sees it. But here's another part you may not want him to know is the next verse, and it says, you know how foolish I have been. Don't raise your hand. Have you been foolish recently? Have you made any poor choices? Have you ever done any dumb things? Here's the bad news. I'll give the bad news first. There is no like off the clock with God. You're on with God 24/7. He sees it all. He knows it all. There's nothing hidden from his eyes. He sees the deed. He sees the motive. He sees it all. But here's the good news. He loves me anyways. He sees it, but he also loves me anyways, and he's never going to give up on me because of his amazing love. God knows, but here's the second thing. He not just knows, he cares. On this Mother's Day, somebody needs to hear this. God cares. He not only just knows about your situation, he cares about what you're going through right now. Psalms 103:13. He is like a father to us, tender and sympathetic. He knows that we are made of dust. He knows that you're made of dust, that you're fragile. By nature, we are not as strong as we think. We're more weak, and we do silly things sometimes. In fact, I modeled this scripture at one time when I was preaching. It was a different translation of that scripture, but this is what the other translation says this, for he himself knows our frame. He is mindful that we are but dust. But I was all excited and pumped up, and I'm into it, but I emphasized but. And I said that we are nothing but dust. And the whole place went crazy. I couldn't get them back. And what did I say? And then Lydia's in the front row doing what she's doing right now. She always does that to me. He did it again. Because I told everybody we're butt dust. That was about 10 years ago. I have never used that scripture again. That translation, I stay away from it. But when we say things and do things like that, here's the good news. That scripture says that God is our Father who is tender and sympathetic. That's apparent. A lot of you had that growing up, but some of you didn't. And Father is saying, I want to be your Abba, your Papa, that is tender and sympathetic to your needs. So I not only know what goes on in your life, I know the pain, I know the sorrow, the brokenness, but I care about it. But here's the best news of all, and that is that God not only knows and cares, God can change me and my situation. God can change me. How many of you know sometimes God changes you? Sometimes he changes the situation. And then sometimes he changes both you and the situation. But in any case, God knows, God cares, and God will change you or the problem. I love this next scripture, Ephesians 1, 19 and 20. Paul says, I pray that you will understand the incredible greatness of God's power, the incredible greatness of God's power for us who believe him. Watch this. This is the same mighty power that raised Christ from the dead and seated him in the place of honor at God's right hand in the heavenly realms. Now, here's what I propose to you. If God, the Almighty, can raise his son Jesus from the dead and restore him back to life, can God not only restore your dead relationship? Can God not restore your dead dreams, your dead emotions? The same Spirit, the exact same Holy Spirit that caused Jesus to come out of that tomb is the same Holy Spirit that lives inside of you that causes things to come alive that are dead. And God restores them back to life. So I got to ask you, what is dead in your life this Mother's Day? What's just dead? It's no longer alive in you or in your life. Or that is the very thing that God wants to make come alive and restore by the power of the Holy Spirit in us. H, higher power. O, open to change. P, power to change. And then E, expect to change. Expect to change. I'm going to say it again because we said it earlier. Just a reminder, if you don't expect to change, you never will. According to your faith, Jesus says, it will be done to you. If I expect not to change, I'm not going to be restored, I'm not going to be recovered from this, then I won't. So I got to know that God is going to help me. He's going to fill me with His Spirit, fill me with His power, divine power, and then I can begin to expect to change in my life. Jesus said this. He said, what is impossible with men, with humans, is possible with God. Would you say that with me? What is impossible with men? It's possible. James, I have an impossible marriage. I have an impossible financial situation. I have an impossible relationship. With God, all things are possible. And God sent me here today to tell you, and to tell those of you watching online, with God, all things are possible. Believe in your heart, and God will begin to change and transform and restore your life. Here at New Life, I could just tell you hundreds and hundreds of stories of people over the last 6 months. That 6 months ago, they were in an impossible situation, but now they're walking in freedom and restoration. Now, I'm going to give just a couple of examples right now. Our PTO ministry, it's a healing ministry, Peel the Onion, just got through with their six-month journey. They had a retreat. And I just got some letters in. People tell me, this is what happened in my life. Will, he sent me an email, and he said, Pastor James, I've loved Jesus all my life, but I've had this addiction to pornography off and on, and just struggled. He said, but now I can tell you that shame is gone from my life. I have been walking in freedom from pornography now for months and months. Will's wife, Michelle, said that she had walked through an ugly divorce some time back, and she was full of it was an ugly thing, and she was abused, and she said, my life was just wrecked. Michelle says, now at the end of this PTO journey, Jesus Christ has healed my heart. In fact, her words was this, her exact words was, now I am free. I am free. Evelyn, I just got to read this to you. It just made me so proud. She says, my name is Evelyn, a powerful and loved child of God. Yet that's not how I came into PTO. I came in the worst moments of my life. And if you'd have asked me to define myself, I would have introduced myself more like this. My name is Evelyn, a defeated, abandoned, rejected, and ugly child of God. But going through PTO helped me to see that I'm not defined by me or the world, but I am defined by God. I am who God says I am, a powerful and loved child of God. Man, it doesn't get any better than that. See, God wants you to get future focused again. As I was driving to church this morning, I tried to visualize myself doing what I'm about to tell you, but can you imagine if you're driving and you only looked in your rear view mirror? That's all you look at. You're not looking out the windshield. You're only looking in the rear view mirror. I did that for about 30 seconds this morning, almost crashed 3 times. Don't try it. But here's what I'm trying to say. A lot of us are stuck back here. The divorce I went through, the abuse I went through, the hurt I went through, whatever it may have been done to you, you did it to yourself, whatever, but you're looking in the rear view mirror and you're always doing that. And here's what Jesus is saying to us today. The restorer, the healer is saying to us, I want to help you. Get your eyes back on the windshield and get your eyes off of the rear view mirror. I want to help you to get unstuck from your past. The pain, the sorrow, your self-image. And the only way you can do that is to plug into the power of God. The power of God. I love this next verse in Philippians 2:13. Paul says, for God is working, watch this, God is working where? God is working in you, giving you the will, the desire, and the power to achieve his purposes. God wants to give you not only the power to do it, he wants to change even your desires. For God is at work in you, changing you from the inside out, metamorphosis, giving you the will, the desire, and then infusing you with the power of the Holy Spirit to change you and to transform you. And this is what happens, and I'll conclude with this. By the way, you know what happens when a pastor says, in conclusion? Nothing. It means absolutely nothing. So in conclusion, if you plug into the power of God, there are three blessings you're going to get, three gifts you're going to get from heaven. Power, love, and self-control. For the spirit that God gives us does not make us timid. Instead, his spirit fill, his wind, his energy, the spirit of God fills us with power. Watch this. Power to break our bad habits. Power to get over our past. Power to get past our shame. Power and love. You'll learn to love as God has loved you. You'll learn to love yourself. And you'll learn to love that most unlovable person in your life. Don't look at them, but you know what I'm talking about. Power, love, and self-control. That is the thing we all desire more of. Saying no to the things of the flesh that are destroying our lives that we just can't help but to keep doing sometimes. And yet the Lord's saying, I want to put my spirit in you. I want to give you power so that you can have self-control and you can change. Be filled with hope today that Jesus the Restorer is alive and well, and his spirit fills the earth, and his spirit fills your heart. And if you tap into that power, you just wait, you just watch. You're going to have hope to change. You will change. Let's pray. Would you bow your heads? Close your eyes. Spirit of Jesus, I ask you to fill our hearts, fill this room, fill this moment, wherever a person is at right now, watching this online, on their device, in a hotel room, wherever they're at, Jesus. Come now in the power of the Spirit. I want to ask you to pray with me through hope, higher power. I want you to ask Jesus, Jesus, I want you to be God in my heart. I want you to be the higher power. You are seated at the Father's right hand, and all angels bow before you, the elders of heaven, the saints that have gone to heaven. Some of our mothers are there right now. They're kneeling before you. Jesus, you are king above it all. Jesus, be king of my heart. Just say yes, Lord. That's my prayer. Open to change. Jesus. In fact, some of you may just want to open up your hands to Jesus, just kind of palms up and say, Lord, I'm open to change, God. I'm open to being transformed. I can't do it on my own. I'm open, Jesus. Spirit of the Lord, fill my heart today. Power to change. God right now is just releasing the power of the Spirit into your heart, into your soul. Spirit of Jesus, just fill us with the power of the Holy Ghost right now. Power from heaven. Power to change. Give us the will and the power to become the people we want to become. And we want to begin to expect to change. Expect. Lord, from this Mother's Day on, we will expect. We have faith. We're going to change. We're going to become. We're going to be restored. We're going to heal up. We're going to repair. Jesus. Now, with our heads still bowed, our eyes still closed, there's some of you today that your walk with God is not where you want it to be. Maybe you've never even started that personal relationship with Jesus Christ. And I'm going to ask you to do that right now. Because as you do, you open your heart to Jesus. The Spirit of Jesus fills you, and he gives you forgiveness, and he gives you power and self-control, and he gives you the hope of heaven. He forgives you of your sins. So with your heads bowed, your eyes closed, this is a very sacred moment. Somebody's making an eternal decision right now, both here and online. If that's you, I'm not going to ask you to come down front, but I'm going to ask you to let me know that you're praying with me. I just want to see who's praying with me today. And on the count of three, I want to ask you to raise up your hand and let me know if that's your decision. You're coming to Jesus to begin this relationship. One, two, three. Just raise your hand up. Yeah, lift them up high. I can see you. Yeah, hands going up all over the room. Yes, beautiful. Thank you, thank you. You're watching online, raise up your hand to heaven. And I want all of us to now pray this prayer from the bottom of our hearts and pray it out loud. Everybody say, Jesus Christ, King of the universe, right now, I choose to make you my higher power. Please come into my heart, fill me with your Spirit so I can experience complete forgiveness of my past mess ups. And I want you to give me power to change my life. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your promise of eternal life, because I've put my trust and my hope in you alone. In your strong name I pray, Jesus. Amen. Come on, new life. Let's celebrate with the angels of heaven.
Well, please remain seated for just a moment. We're going to release you in just a second. But if you just made that decision and you accepted Christ, we are so honored to be a part of your spiritual journey. Here in just a moment, when we release you, there are some yes packets in the back of the room. We would love for you to pick one of those up, and you can go out to our Welcome Center, where our Next Steps team would love to answer any questions that you have. You see, it's been brought to our attention that some of you who are picking up your kids on Sunday are having a little bit of a congestion problem. So we have opened up in the back of our kids ministry our south and our north entrances. So once you go through and you pick up your children here in just a moment on the way out, you don't have to come back into the family room. You can exit out the south and the north doors for safety and protection. For all of you who came in to the north entrance, the south entrance, I just want to remind you that out here at the north entrance, for all you mamas today, we have some specialty free iced coffee drinks for you. And you can buy your mama a churro out there too, and just have some fun on your way out today. Like I said, our prayer teams are coming down front. If you would like further prayer, please come and partner with them. They have been praying for you all week. And as Pastor said, part of your next steps is to seek water baptism. So our baptism team is over here, and they are ready for you as well. Can you stand to your feet, New Life Church, and allow me to bless you as we leave today? I bless you in the name of Jesus. And I pray that as you leave here today, you are restored with the hope and the power of the Spirit that is alive within you. I pray favor and grace over your life as you leave here today. Have a wonderful week, New Life Church. Go in peace, and we'll see you back next Sunday.
Thank you. Bakersfield.